This is Match Game 74, production number 0221. Air date to be announced, VT Yard 51774, take one. Get ready to match the star. Nipsey Russel. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Jackie Joseph. Richard Dawson. And Joanne Worley. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us here. You got them all riled up again, eh, John? Nice to have you with us. And all us old folks will say hello to the new kid on the block. This familiar
you.
Face here.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Jackie, we're delighted to have you here. Jackie and Joseph. You have a question?
I do not like being referred to at my age as an old folk. I'm nervous enough.
Oh, listen.
An old folk.
You're not old. You yes. arouse my libido day after day, week after week.
Oh.
And now the moment is
coming. Oh, thank
heavens.
Guard.
Do we have to match
that's the
that?
Musical of the old folks at home.
All right, I guess our celebrities are ready, so let's say hello to our two players, Karen O'Day and Susan Underwood. How are you? Karen O'Day has won $10,600. She's got five games under her belt, and she's very happy about that. She's being challenged by Susan Underwood. We've finished one round, and at the moment, the champ is ahead 4-1. We are going to get to round two right after we get to this message for you. Oh, yes, indeed.
Ready.
Okay, 4-1 the score. Let's begin our second and final round. Ask Susan Underwood, the challenger, to make a selection.
I'll take B, please.
B. Now, last time you matched Charles. So, Charles, you lay out. The rest of you, we have this for you. Everyone in the land of Oz was surprised when the Tin Man blanked a garbage can. Everyone in the land of Oz was surprised when the Tin Man blanked a garbage can.
Da-da-da.
Well,
is that the same wig you wore last week?
Yes,
no, it's my...
No, this isn't the same. I was wearing my Polly Bergen last week. This is my Eve Arden.
This is a darling one, too.
Wig?
She,
wig?
Wig?
What
no.
is happening?
No, I'm sorry. No. Okay.
It's like glasses, only...
Now,
different.
Susan, we need a response from you. Everyone in the land of Oz was surprised when the Tin Man blanked a garbage can.
Kissed.
Kissed a garbage can.
I can't figure it.
I guess a Tin Man could kiss a garbage can if he wanted to.
If he knew
especially
it.
If it was galvanized. I mean, I would. What did you say?
Yeah, well, you shouldn't do those things unless you were married.
Oh, he married a garbage
he
can.
He did.
Oh, I see.
Bird of
all
a
right,
feather.
Brett.
Well, I thought he was picking on one of his own. No offense, Lipsy. And said kicked.
Kicked a garbage can. I see. Okay, now you've got to match the remaining three celebrity students, Susan, to stay in the game. Jackie?
Oh, I thought he knew it well and they got married.
Married. So there is no match, and that means Karen O'Day wins the game. Congratulations. Okay. Sorry you gotta go, Susan, but you gotta go. We've got a gift for you together with our thanks. I hope you enjoyed it.
It was a lot of fun.
Good.
Really
Susan
bye,
Underwood,
Charles.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Bye,
Karen, this is the sixth game you've won. You're excited, are you?
Yes.
Hold on, that's all right. Hang on to me.
That's enough.
No, that's okay. You just keep on hanging on to me. Karen O'Day is now up to $10,700. She's going to have a go at over $5,000 here at the Big Money Supermatch. You ready?
Ready.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank downs. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. If you match the third one, you get $100. Okay. Three celebrities are allowed to give a little assist here. Which ones do you choose?
Richard.
Hugh Downs.
Hugh Downs. Okay. All right, there's one.
Nipsey.
Of course, an old racing buff would say Churchill Downs.
Churchill Downs.
Joanne.
Well, I think ups and downs, right?
Ups and downs.
All right.
So you've got ups and downs, you've got Hugh Downs, and you've got Churchill Downs. Now, Karen, you may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Hugh Downs.
You'd like to do Hugh Downs? What kind of talk is that there? Okay. Hugh Downs is the answer she's looking for, the one that Richard gave her. Let's find out if that is up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Churchill Downs.
Right off the bat.
Nipsey's answer. Okay.
There you are.
That may be a good sign for you, Karen. We'll find out. Looking for Hugh Downs. Here is the $250 response. Hugh Downs!
Hugh Downs.
Congratulations. Johnny Olson, what do you think is up under there, under the $500
thing
there?
Ups and.
Ups and? You think he's right?
Yeah.
I say
no?
Nipsey Downs.
What do you say? Hand me down.
Oh, that's a good one.
All right, here is the $500 response.
Sit down.
Ups and down.
Imagine.
That was your answer, right, Joanne?
Yeah.
Okay, now, Karen, you've got the $250. That means you'll play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. To collect that amount, you must match one ding-a-ling on a head-to-head basis. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Richard is the ding-a-ling. Okay. You face me, Karen? This is your sixth game.
My knees are shaking just a bit. How's they were before?
Your knees are still shaking, man. Okay, here we go. You write your response to this. Gum blank. That's G-U-M blank. He's finished. Now, which answer would you like to give us in order to try to match Richard? Gum?
Gumball.
Gumball. This is right. All right. That's the answer she thinks will match you, Richard. So for $2,500, may we see your response?
My younger son, Gary, has a nickname that I've called him ever since he was that high. And it's Gumdrop.
Gumdrop.
Yeah.
That's a good answer.
I'm sorry.
Gumdrop and Gumball were both good. What did you have, Charles?
That...
Did you gumshoe, have gum there's another good
he
one.
Had gum
yeah.
boil.
I had gum boil because...
because of his hair
I don't
and
do
his
what
eyes
you
and
do.
His
what
teeth.
Do you do? Yeah. Shave chap.
What's
the
that?
Teeth. How are you telling me to brush my teeth?
Oh, to get rid of the plaque. You
yes.
brush your teeth in
that's...
a certain way, yes.
I love to... dental shows, don't you,
yes.
Dick?
I'm sorry you've got so many problems, Charles. The
all
medical
right,
show
Charles,
is on another network.
Is better than no breath at all.
Listen,
my mouth is a bit.
$10,950, and you'll play another game right after this message. All right, we're going to start a brand new game, and to do so, we welcome a new player. So let's say hello to Wayne Roundtree.
Hello,
Wayne. You know Karen?
Yes.
And we'll ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, Wayne.
Well, I'm a manager at a carpet store, married happily for 2 years, and I have a dune buggy I like to off-road a lot.
You have a dune buggy?
Yes, and I like to off-road, in the desert.
Well, you like to off-road. We don't have that expression in the East.
I don't understand what he said.
He says he likes to off-road.
I don't even know what that means, darling.
Well,
that
in the desert, you just drive around.
Oh, in the desert, where there are no roads. Yeah,
yeah.
That's interesting.
You run into something, you don't get hurt. It's real.
You're a natural blonde. All right, Wayne, you're the challenger. You'll make a selection, if you would, please.
You want to push the button first?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Love.
One MC per show. Thank you anyway for
he
reminding me.
He likes off-road
push
too.
The button. And now we're ready for you.
I'll try B.
Here it is for the smart aleck folks. Raquel said, I met this weirdo who claimed to be William Tell. Instead of shooting an apple off my head, he wanted to shoot a blank off my chest. Watch it, madam. Raquel said, I met this weirdo who claimed to be William Tell. Instead of shooting an apple off my head, he wanted to shoot a blank off my chest. Do you think about that, Wayne? While the celebrities write an answer there. Stop writing an answer there.
I don't understand the question.
Hey, would you, instead of shooting an apple off my head?
I understand the words. I don't understand it when you put them all together.
Oh. Have you been sick since our last show?
Oh, I haven't been at all well.
It'll be all right when the plane lands, folks.
Here we go. Wayne. Raquel said, I met this weirdo who claimed to be William Tell. Instead of shooting an apple off my head, he wanted to shoot a blank off my chest.
Apple. That's all I could think of.
They're going to hurt him.
They're owing a natural blonde. Guy who never dips into the peroxide once in his whole life, and they're awing him there. He has blonde roots, too. Okay, he says an apple...
Recently dipped.
Off, an apple off my chest is what he said. Nipsey?
Well, he was a marksman. He wanted something that would blow around in the wind, so he wanted to shoot a balloon.
A balloon off my chest, okay.
I wish to preface this entire thing. I did not understand the question. Now, I'm serious. I just put hand and just let it go with that.
And do you know we do not understand the answer either?
Yeah.
Charles,
I don't know what she's talking
about.
Charles, what do you say?
Off her chest?
Yes.
A double martini.
Thank you very much. Did you hear what he said, a double martini?
Yeah, I heard that.
All right, here's the first one from the new girl on the block.
I know. Next.
Go ahead.
Oh.
No, you.
Well, an apple, I thought, would just slide right through, so I said a watermelon.
A watermelon.
I resemble that.
Right on.
We still got an apple for you. Yeah, are you offering any kind of fruit or anything edible there?
Just a second.
Charles?
Yes, darling.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes. This is a very revealing answer, Wayne.
Yes.
He wanted to shoot a bra off her chest.
Now I get the question.
He'd be quite a marksman if he
How's
could
do he
that,
gonna do
you?
That? Ricochet bullets?
Yes.
That would hurt her.
You know, not if he were a good shot. Right. What did
well,
you say?
This is a very simple question because the only possible thing that if it isn't an apple,
can we get back to the watermelon?
He wanted to shoot a pear off her chest.
Okay.
Very good.
So there's no match there for you, Wayne. But well, let's see what we've got for Karen O'Day. When Richard Dawson applied for the job as the human cannonball, they asked about his experience, and Richard said, I've never been shot out of a cannon, but once I was thrown out of a blank.
It's no fair, he knows the answer.
Yeah, he was there.
I've never been shot out of a cannon, but once I was thrown out of a blank. Charles, you're the first one finished.
I'm ready. My next appearance, network-wise, will be...
I'm finished.
And then my new book.
All right.
And then my album.
I hit a blank there.
All right.
Okay.
Really?
Try chair.
Try hand.
Okay.
Okay.
Everybody what can I now? Say?
When Richard Dawson applied for the job as the human cannonball, they asked about his experience, and he said, I've never been shot out of a cannon, but once I was thrown out of a...
Bar.
Bar.
I don't drink.
You don't drink?
That's why they
How does she know that? There. Nipsey, what'd you say?
He doesn't drink, right? So
That's
it wasn't thrown out of a bar. Okay, what are you going to say when I say once you were thrown out of a hotel?
Well, that happens every other week.
Brett, what did you say?
I think it's the same thing, actually. I didn't say hand. Cheer up. I said saloon.
Saloon. And bar would be an axe, okay?
What did you say?
Hand charm.
Actually, it was an ice cream bar.
A bar.
And he was looking for his son, Gumdrop. Stay tuned in for next week.
What did you say?
You know, I really know a human cannonball.
You do?
Yes, he was in the army with my husband. His name is Hugo Zucchini.
That's your husband? People. I thought it was Ken Berry.
No, cannonball was Hugo.
Zucchini. I heard he was fired.
Yes, the great zucchini. He was fired from the cannon, yes. since Richard doesn't drink, that's why they threw him out of the
they
bar.
They shot him at Rocky. Yeah, well, yes.
Okay, what did this
well,
start?
I had to be truthful.
Yeah.
On more than one occasion, I have been thrown out of a bend.
cocktail over the bar.
They mark you down as a no-show.
I've never been shown out of a cannon, but once I was thrown out of a bed. Yeah. What did you say?
Well,
you
know I know, of course, that he doesn't drink, and I can't imagine this happening, but I'm sure he's been thrown out of a car.
Car?
That's right.
That could be. Okay, so that's three for you and none for you, and that's the end of round one. Round two coming up right after this.
Today's consolation prizes are Charm Glowette, the completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere, instant flame without starter fluids and charcoal, Charm Glow products of Antioch, Illinois. And Kikkoman soy sauce, the great natural seasoning that's ideal for giving steaks, chicken, hamburgers, and fish a wonderfully special zest. And Woodcrafter furniture polish to give you real paste wax shine and protection. Woodcrafter hand rub beauty in a spray. Match game 74 will carry on in just a minute.
Science is no use.
Okay, round one is over. I'll push a button, reveal the questions for round two, our final round. Wayne, what do you say?
I'll try B again.
B again. That's what he had last time. Didn't do well with it. Let's see how he does with it now. The incredible shrinking man shrank so much he was blanked by a fly.
Oh! So nice
the
when I
The incredible shrinking man shrank so much he was blanked by a fly. Everybody's busy writing over here.
I'm finished.
Then we know it's a short word.
No, strange enough, she wrote down everything she knew on the paper. She's finished.
All right, they're all set. So, Wayne, we call on you. The incredible shrinking man shrank so much, he was blanked by a fly.
Eight.
Eight. All right. You've got to match three celebrities to stay in the game. He was ate by a fly, he
well,
said.
Well, being from the South.
I mean, he may have natural hair, but his grammar leaves something to be desired.
Don't let him bother you,
Wayne.
Being from Georgia, I would have said he was it by a fly, but I wrote he was eaten by a fly.
Eaten by a fly. Save it and do it yourself. All right, Brett.
I'm not giving my answer until Mr. Roundtree tells me his origin.
I would imagine if I had to guess, it would be Danish.
Pole.
Your progenitors must have been Danes, right?
No, I mean, where are you from? What part of this country?
Oh, no,
that was close.
Dallas, Texas.
Oh, yeah! I knew you
and
were
are you Danish?
Funny part. But don't
no?
you want to hear my
Are
answer?
You St. Bernard?
No. All right, now that you've gotten us off on another track, do you want to go back to the game?
Yes, I just want... Well, you know, my friend Angelique's from Texas.
What'd you write, Brett?
Nobody... You're not... When you get to be the host, you get to ask the question.
What'd you write, Brett?
I wrote at.
Okay. That's two for you. Charles?
She just wants you to get out in that camper out in the desert road. They say sometimes they don't find the women for 6 to 8 weeks. Swatted.
Swatted by a fly. Okay. What's that? Yeah, I guess I better read it again. The incredible shrinking man shrank so much he was blanked by a fly. Wayne said eight. What do you say?
Well, that poor little shrunken person was eaten.
Eaten by a fly. Or eaten.
Okay, Wayne, come on. Let's get it for Wayne.
Richard, what do you say about this? He was ate by a fly.
He was so small, I happen to know that he was deaded by a fly.
Deaded?
Or killed.
He was killed.
It was a horrible sight.
And then he...
Down the fly came.
Yes.
Hi, say
it.
Well, I'll tell you
I don't
want
to hear about it. All right. Joanne?
Where are you from, Wayne?
I happen to have marvelous grammar, but I believe in telepathy, and I picked up his word.
Hey! So at this moment, it's 4-3. Now we'll finish the round. You need one to tie, and two will win another game. You're seventh, if it happens. Okay, last time out, you matched three of our celebrities, Brett, Charles, and Jackie, and the three of you will not participate in this. The others will. Hansel said to Gretel, "That wicked witch is so ugly, even her blanks have warts." Really?
It's your first time in the show.
We finished down here.
Oh, you're all set. Oh, I'm finished down here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Takes longer if you want to use good grammar.
All right. Okay, Nipsey, ready?
I'm ready.
All right, Karen O'Day, we call on you. Hansel said to Gretel, "That wicked witch is so ugly, even her blanks have warts."
Oh. Her...
Even her what?
Her hands.
Even her hands have warts?
I know, it's bad.
Oh.
I had nose in my mind, but I didn't know you said blanks.
Her, even her blanks have warts. Okay, even her hands have warts. She says.
She
and the audience gave her a
ugly.
Big groan on that. Nipsey, what
you
do you
see,
give her?
You see, beauty is only skin deep, but ugly is to the bone.
Yeah.
Even her warts have warts.
That's the answer. Okay. Now, let's see. We come down here to Richard Dawson.
That's right. Even her warts have warts.
Now, you've got to match Joanne, or Wayne Roundtree will be the new champion. Let's find out, Joanne, if she matches you.
Her hands were full of warts, and on top were warts?
So, Wayne Roundtree is the winner. Congratulations. Congratulations. There's $100 for you. Stand by for a moment, Wayne. We've got to say goodbye to this lady. She's not going to be real unhappy to go. Have you had a good time?
Oh, great. Thank
you,
everybody.
What are you going to do with the money, Karen?
Have a swimming pool.
You're going to have a swimming pool. Well, you've got $10,950. Congratulations. You're marvelous. Karen O'Day. We'll get back to you in a moment or so, but first we've got to do a little business here. That's nothing.
Yes.
But this is something. This group of six, you were really splendid.
Oh, thank you, sir.
You will come back again next time.
Without
doubt. Aunt Will.
I'm all staying right. Over.
How was it your first
the
time
cards
around?
Are blue. I never knew that.
What? You mean you watch it at home? You always
every
thought the
day
cards?
Every day I'm an audience.
Oh, aren't you marvelous?
Big fan.
Well, good. We're glad to have you here. All right.
Get Jackie to take your hat off.
Take your hat off.
Her maybe head comes with it.
So.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Maybe Jackie will take her hat off.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.